are gearing up for a money-spinning away day at Premier League Dunfermline. The non-leaguers completed the cup upset of the season so far when they beat 3rd Division East Stirlingshire in a penalty shootout. As Graham Moss reports, the celebrations have been taking place from Meadowbank to Moscow.
120 muddy Meadowbank minutes failed to produce a goal in this second round replay. East Stirling in the green failing to convert any of their numerous chances. At times, the 3rd Division side seemed intent on knocking themselves out, literally. Penalties determined the outcome. Edinburgh's Tom Nolan with the decisive kick, securing that third round pairing with Premier League Dunfermline.
I just decided to put it the same way as always, to the keeper's left, and he actually moved a wee bit, made my job a bit easier for putting it in the left-hand corner. To the club, it's a bonus for the supporters that come every week, a big lift.
Nolan wasn't Edinburgh's only hero. Keeper Alan McIntosh played his part with two penalty saves during the shootout.
After the penalties, I felt drained because, I mean, the adrenaline had been pumping the whole game. But just so happy. It was an amazing feeling. There was quite a big crowd there for us. And when I heard the cheer, when I seen Tommy put his penalty, it was just brilliant. Nobody could stop me.
One absentee was the club chairman, but a business trip to Moscow couldn't prevent him sharing in the moment.
We kept in touch by receiving messages over the mobile phone. We did not have the information about extra time and penalties until it had actually finished. I think it's probably the most important thing that's happened to the club. Last night was our cup final.
So how does the Edinburgh manager, former Hibs defender Gordon Ray, rate City's first Scottish Cup win since 1939?
Well, even though I've already played at Hampden in a Scottish Cup final, qualifying for the third round last night was still, it's probably the pinnacle. It's been outstanding. It's great for the boys, it's great for the club. And again, it just shows how far we have come.
The message now from the Minnows, Dunfermline watch out.
Well done to them. Well, two.
But the third round isn't just about the clubs in with a serious chance of winning the competition. It's a day for the Minnows as well. Cup romance is what it's all about. And if you're talking romantics, you're probably not talking Chick Young.
You know, the wonderful thing about this great Scottish Cup adventure of mine is that it's a fantastic geographical education for a boy from Glasgow. We've been to Fraserburgh in the northeast, Stranraer in the southwest, and now we're in a little tax haven in the east called Edinburgh. But this isn't a tale of the pride of Gorgeir Leith. This is a story of Edinburgh City, of whom you might have been entitled to say, Edinburgh who? Hey, but that's not a question that East Stirling would dare to ask after the second round. City are sitting pretty with a game against Premier Division Dunfermline tomorrow. And more than anything else, that means making a fool of yourself for the back pages of the tabloid papers. These are the wide open spaces of the stand here at Meadowbank Stadium. And if you think I look a bit sad and lonely, don't worry about it. Things aren't too different on a Saturday when Edinburgh City are playing here. But why listen to me going about the team? Let me introduce you to a man who can tell you so much more. And he can do it in new British, European, Commonwealth and world record time.
Edinburgh City Football Club were formed in 1928 as the capital's equivalent of Queen's Park, an amateur football team taking part in senior football. They joined the Scottish League in 1931, where they remained for 18 years, but never finished higher than fourth from bottom. Their best result was beating Hibs 3-2 in the Scottish Cup in 1938. They turned junior in 1949 and went defunct in 1955. Throughout this time period, though, a social club continued, and they gave permission for an East of Scotland League team to revive the name in 1986. The club was then reformed. In 1996, they were given permission to play their home matches at Meadowbank Stadium, which allowed them to get back into the SFA, which got them back into the Scottish Qualifying Cup, which brought them here today.
There's one thing about Edinburgh City. They don't mind washing their dirty laundry in public. In fact, the manager will do it for £8. Former Hibs defender Gordon Ray runs a company which cleans the gear of amateur and junior sides in the Edinburgh area, and that makes him the only manager in football who gets into a lather after every game.
Their big problem will really be Saturday, keep their feet on the ground until Saturday. They're either going to be just on a natural high, or they've got to be totally exhausted. But they're a great bunch of boys. They try to do what we do, and we're limited at the time and the time we can work with them. We've only got two nights, and our facilities are pretty basic. But to be fair, they work hard, and they try and take in what we tell them, and we treat them like professionals, and they've reacted like professionals.
This is the day of their life, isn't it?
Definitely. It's the day of our lives. I mean, I said that last week. Saturday will be the best day of my career, and hopefully Bernard won in a couple of weeks. That's football
for you. But you've been in a cup final.
I know, but you couldn't buy that feeling after last Monday night. You couldn't buy it. And they're still buzzing the place. You really, honest chick, you couldn't buy it. The place was buzzing. There was boys in tears. It was incredible. And then, I mean, you feel great, and you see that, and you think, well, was it really the greatest day of my career? But I'll tell you, it was. And then you get a result on Saturday, and that'll be the best, and you win a cup at the end of the season. It's an old football thing. It's brilliant. It's different class. Don't wanna stop it.